Properties of conditional probability. If E and F, these are events of some sample space S, then we have property 1 is P S by F. This is sample space, this is F. P S by F is equal to P F by F, which is equal to 1. How? See, P S by F is nothing but P S intersection F by P F. Okay? Then this P S intersection F is nothing but, because if you take a total sample space and then intersect it with some F, you will get F only. So you get P F, and this is again P F. PF, PF is 1. How about PF by F? This is PF intersection F, and anything intersecting with itself is itself. So PF, and PF by PF is again 1. So PS by F is equal to PF by F is equal to 1. If A and B are any two events of sample space S and F, this is an event, F is an event of S. See, F, this sample space is S, F is an event of S. And if we have A and B are any two events of that same sample space F, S, then P A union B divided by F, this is not divided actually, by F, that is probability of this if F has happened. Then P A by F plus P B by F minus P A intersection B by F. So in particular, if A and B, they are disjoint set, then you don't get this. P A union B by F gives A P A by F plus P B by F. And P A union B by F is simply P A union B intersection F by PF, and just distribute them, P A intersection F union P B intersection F by PF. Now here we know that this is what we have taken from the previous this one. Okay, we can take this one. So let us separate them, this one and this one. So let us separate them. This is P A by F, this is P B by F. And this is nothing but P minus, this minus P A intersection B by F. And if A and B are disjoint set, then this is going to be 0. So what you get? If this is 0, you get only this. So P A union B by F, if A and B are disjoint, P A by F plus P B by F. How about P E complement F is equal to 1 minus P E by F? And we know from the first property that P S by F is 1. So what is S? S is nothing but anything, take X and union X complement. So all sample space will be the value, the variable and the or the set or the complement of that set. We know this. So E union E complement is S. So you can write S, E union E complement in place of S. So this becomes P E by F plus P E complement by F, which is equal to 1. Take all this on the right hand side. So this is exactly equal to the property 3. PA is this, PB is this, PA intersection B is this. You have to find PA by B. PA by B is nothing but PA intersection B by PB. So PA intersection B by PB, PA intersection B is this, PB is 9 by 13, this is 4 by 9. A family has two children. What is the probability that both the children are boys, given that at least one of them is a boy? Now, first we'll try to make the sample space. If B stands for boy and G stands for girl, then the sample space will be boy boy, girl boy, girl, girl girl. Okay. Now let us take E and F as these events. Like E is the both the children are boys. This is the both the children are boys. First we have taken this. Then the F is at least one of them is boy. So we have taken both the events. So what is E? Both the children are boys. Only this one. At least one of the children is boy. 1, 2, 3. F contains these 3, E contains this. What is the intersection of E and F? See, only BB is common. So it will be BB. That is only 1. And what is PF? PF is what? PF is, you see, these are 3 members. These are the 3 favorable case and this is the sample space. So 3 by 4. 3 by 4. How about PE intersection F? This is only 1 and 4 is the sample space. 1 by 4. What is PE by F? That is, both the children are boys, given that both the children are boy, given that one of them is a boy, at least one of them is a boy. So PE intersection F by PF, this is 1 by 4, this is 3 by 4, this becomes 1 by 4. 10 cards number 1 to 10 are placed in box, mixed up thoroughly, and then one card is drawn randomly. If it is known that the number on the drawn card is more than 3, what is the probability that it is an even number? So when we have a card, let us first write the sample space. S is nothing but 1 to 10. This is our sample space. Now take A as the event, the number on the card, see, this one. The number on the card drawn is even. We have taken it as A. And B as the number on the card is greater than 3. So number on the card which is greater than 3, this we have taken as B. So we have to find out the probability P A by B, that is, what is the probability that it is even number if it is known that the number on the card is more than 3. So P A by B you have to find out. So what will be A? A is the number on the card, or the card is even. So it will be 2, 4, 6, 8 and 10. This is A. How about B? B is the number on the card which is greater than 3. So all these will come. Right? This B has come. What is A intersection B? A intersection B, what are these? What are the common values in this and this? 4, 6, 8, 10. Now, PA is what? These are 5. Sample space is 10. So 5 by 10. How about PB? These are 7. Sample space is 10. So 7 by 10. P intersection B. These are 4. Sample space is 10. 4 by 10. Now you have known all the probabilities. You just have to find PA by B. This is PA intersection B by PB. That is 4 by 10. 7 by 10. This is 4 by 7. In a school, there are 1000 students, out of which 430 are girls. So 430 are girls, it is being given. It is known that out of 430, 10% of the girls, they study in class 10. What is the probability that a student chosen randomly studies in class 12, given that the chosen student is a girl? So we'll take one event as girl chosen is chosen girl. We have chosen a girl, and the second one, that the student chosen from class 12. Let us take it. Let E be the event that the student chosen randomly studies in class 12. This we have taken. F is the event that randomly chosen student is a girl. E and F. So we have to find, according to this question, this is P E by F. That is the probability that the student chosen randomly studies in class 12, and F, that it is known that the chosen student is the girl. I hope this is understood. Now let us find out the probability. How many total sample space is 1000? And how about the PF, that is F is the randomly chosen student is a girl. So because there are 430 girls, 430 by 1000 will be the probability of PF. How about PE intersection F? P intersection F is nothing but 43. This is 43 because 43, 10% in total of 430, 10% of them are in class 12. So 43 comes from 430 into 10%. So what do you get? 10%. You get here 43 by 1000. So this is 0.043. So what is PE by F? What do you get here? PE by F. This is P intersection F. You have to find this. P intersection F by PF. So this is, these two values, just put it, you will get 0.1. A die is thrown 3 times. A die is thrown 3 times. A and B are defined like this. A, 4 on 3rd row, 6 on 1st and 5 on 3rd row. So 4 on 3rd row, 6 and 5 on the 2nd row. Find the probability of A given that B has already occurred. So you have to find P A by B. Right? So P A by B, that means first of all you have to see that these are 3 die. 6 can come in the first one, 6 can come in the second one, 6 can come in the third one. So there are total 216 outcomes, 6 into 6 into 6, right? So these are all outcomes. But we know how we can write this. This is quite easy. 4 on the third row, 4 on the third row, and 6 on first and 5 on second row. So this B will become, see, B is simply 4 on the third row. So just to take 4 on the third row, third throw, row I am saying, but it is throw actually. And B is nothing but 6 on first and, so this is B. B is what? 6 and 5. You have to fix that. 6 in first throw and 5 in second throw. Then 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So in all there are 6. How about A intersection B? There will be only one value, which is 6, 5, 4. Only 6, 5, 4 will come. A intersection B. That means first is 6, second is 5, and the last one is 4. See, 4 on the third row, 4 on the third row, 4 on the third row. So you will get only 6, 5, 4. What is the probability of B? How many are these? 6. Total are 216. How about P, A intersection B? How many are there in A intersection B? 1. Total is 216. Now, PA by B is nothing but PA intersection B by PB. 1 by 216, 6 by 216, this is 1 by 6. A die is thrown twice and the sum of numbers appearing is observed to be 6. What is the probability that the number 4 has appeared at least once? So, if we take E as the event, number 4 appears at least once, and F as the event, the sum of numbers appearing is 6. So, E will be what? Number 4 appears at least once. So, 4, 4, 4, all, you know, all the combination where 4 comes is the F, is the E. And what about F? The sum of the numbers appearing is 6. 1 plus 5, 6. 2 plus 4, 6. 4 plus 2, 6. 3 plus 3, 6. 5 plus 1, 6. So, F becomes this. How many are there? E, the number are 1, 2, till 11. So, these are 11 and these are 5. So, how about PE? Nothing but, P is nothing but your 11, this 11, this is 11 by 36. 36 is total because die is throw twice. 6 into 6 is 36. So, what do you get? 6 into 6, 36, 11 by 36. Then, PF is how many are there? 5. And total is 36, 5 by 36. So, E intersection F is what? Just take values which are common in these two. You get 2, 4 and 4, 2. These are E intersection F. Now, what you have to find out, PE intersection F, that is only 2 by 36 because 2 are only in E intersection F. How about PE by F? PE by F is P intersection F by PF. 2 by 36, put the value of 5 by 36 in place of PF, you get 2 by 5. Right? So, this is how we find out the conditional probability. Consider one more example. That is, we have an experiment of tossing a coin. If the coin shows head, if it comes head, we toss it again, but if it shows tail, then we throw a die. That is, first we throw if head comes, if tail comes, if head comes, then throw it again. That is, head, this head will come, head may come again, this is head, tail may come again. So, head, tail. Now, when you throw a tail, then anything can come between 1 and 6 because after this we throw a die. So, when T1, T2, T3, T4, T5, T6 will come, right? Find the conditional probability of the event that the die shows a number greater than 6. That means these two. That there is at least one tail. There is at least one tail. So, this you have to see. The outcome of the experiment can be represented like this in a tree diagram. First of all, what is the sample space? HH, HT, T1, T2, T3, T4, T5, T6. I hope you got this idea. Now, what are the probabilities? This HH denotes that both the results, tossing result into head. This is HH. And this TI, I can be 1 to 6. This denotes the first toss into tail and the number I appear on the die. 1 to 6 it can come. So, the probability which is assigned to these 8 elementary events, that is these 8 events are nothing but C. Probability of head and tail is half. Probability of again getting head is 1 by 4, half into half, and half into half again 1 by 4. Now, 1 by 2 is this, but there are 6 possibilities. So, 1 by 2 into 1 by 6 is the probability of each of these. 1 by 12, 1 by 12, 1 by 12. Okay. So, this is 1 by 4, 1 by 4, all others are 1 by 12. Now, F is the event that there is at least one tail. And E is the event that the die shows number which is greater than 4. What is F? There is at least one tail. So, HT, T, all these. T, 1, 2, 6. This is F. How about E? The die shows number greater than 4. Die shows number greater than 4. So, T, 5 and T, 6 only die which has number greater than 4 is given. How about E intersection F? Which are common? These two and these two. So, only two are common. How to find the PF? That is probability of PF. This one. Plus this one, all these probability we have to add. So, this is 1 by 4, this is 1 by 12, 1 by 12, 1 by 12, this 6 times. So, you get 3 by 4. How about P intersection F? Probability of this and this. This is 1 by 12, this is 1 by 12. So, 1 by 12 plus 1 by 12, what do you get? 1 by 6. So, PE by F is nothing but P intersection F by PF, that is 1 by 6 by 3 by 4, this is 2 by 9.